Hello, in this video I want to talk about the differences between the Synology DS718 Plus and the DS918 Plus. So on the left we have the 718, on the right we have the 918, and I'll just talk about the spec differences between the two, and then we'll look at the physical features. These both have the Celeron J3455 processor, same speed processor, so nothing different there. There are RAM differences. This one comes with, the 718 comes with 2 gigabytes of RAM, expandable to 6 gigabytes, although, I'll talk about this. This has 4 gigabytes of RAM, expandable to 8, but I've put 16 gig in here, and I'll be doing another video seeing if we can get 16 gig installed in here. But this comes with 2, this one comes with 4. They both have 2 slots. So, and then, a huge difference here is this has 2 drive bays, this has 4. It's pretty obvious. These are both expandable with a 5-bay expansion piece. And so that would take this to 7 and this to 9 bays. This one has 2 M2 slots for cache, M2 NVMe cache. This one does not. This has 3 USB ports. This has 2 USB ports, and this has a copy button, and this does not have a copy button. So let's look at the physical features here. So let me get the camera off here so we can kind of move around here. You see the status lights here. There's one called status here and status here, and then you have LAN 1, LAN 2, and this one has lights within the drive bay, and this has lights for disk 1, 2, 3, and 4 off to the side. So that's kind of a different on the front. This has the copy button, so that, I haven't messed with this, but I think you put a USB drive in here and you can hit the copy button, it'll copy the files from the USB drive to the hard drives. So, that's the front panel. The back, a big difference here you can see is that the smaller one has 1 fan, the bigger one has 2 fans. They both have dual LAN. They both have the eSATA port for expansion. This one has 2 USB ports. This one has 1 USB port. And they both have the Kensington lock back there. So the larger one has a larger power supply than the smaller one. The side has the Synology on the side. Same here. Okay. Now we'll take the I'll take a drive bay out of each of these. So this one you unlock, you pull out, and the drive pulls out. This one, you unlock, and it has kind of a, you click it to pop it out, and it clicks back in. So this one just pulls out. This one has a little clicker thing, so that pulls out. Here are the drive bays. Here. And these seem to slide in to each other, but this doesn't lock. Let's see if this one goes in. So this one goes in but doesn't stay. So the drive bays, and now I have it kind of stuck, so that was really smart of me. So the drive bays are not compatible between the two. So let me see if I can get this out here. There we go. I don't really want to do that again. The key is the same between the two. So I'll pull all the drives out now, keeping them in order. we look inside here, we can see the processor and the two RAM slots. Same thing here, there's a lot more room to get in here. It looks like the RAM slots are kind of reversed. You see the label's out on this one, and on this one the label's in. And you know, I don't have a RAM chip in there, but you can see the notch is on the left here, and on here the notch is on the right. Then you can kind of see the back plane in there, and here's the back plane here. So, and here's the bottom. Got metal on the bottom of this one. This one is plastic. And since this one doesn't have the M2 NVMe, this one does. So you can pop off these ports here and you can see the M2 NVMe. So, so these are kind of the physical differences between these boxes. I talked about the specs. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. And I'll put a link in the comments also to a playlist I have with a number of different videos on both of these devices. But if you have any questions, leave them below. If you like this video, please click like, and thanks for watching. Bye.